Head football coach John Stiegelmeier joins us here at the Dykow Student Athlete Center. And coach, we had talked last year about this facility and, of course, getting ready with Coughlin alumni in the background, painting the field and such as we chat here. But this is special to actually be in this building during football season.
Yeah, it's tremendous, Tyler. It's a one-stop facility. We've used it to the max this fall. We've had breakfast here. We've lifted here. We've watched film here. People always talk about the recruiting. Oh, you can't wait to recruit with it, and that'll be real special. But it's really the benefit of the athletes that's here and all the things he can use it for.
A lot of excitement for this coming year, but I know last year kind of a bitter taste, the way things ended, a great year with the loss to Montana. How have you guys used that loss in the playoffs as motivation for this season?
You know, it's been, people talk about grieving, taking a while. I don't want to put that on that level at all, but you know, I think initially we really just kept thinking about the game, you know, and the hurt, if you will, for a lot of reasons. Now, in my opinion, it is simply the fact that we took another step on our journey as a football program, and we know we've been to the playoffs, and win or lose, you know, we got that out of our system, you know, that we've been there, and we can talk about competing for a championship because we've been in the tournament, really.
We talk a lot, you and I have, about the one game at a time approach and that mantra, so I'm going to be a little risky here. Nebraska's the third game of the year. Can we talk about going to Lincoln?
No. We've got Delaware, and that's all we talk about. And after that, we've got Illinois State. Delaware's 15, Illinois State's 26 in the nation. And, you know, the power of a Nebraska football program and the exposure draws your schedule to that game. But we're not talking about it. We're not thinking about it. And when you said Lincoln, I wasn't really sure what you were talking about. So,
quarterback Thomas O'Brien back to start. He started a significant portion of your season a year ago, a sophomore. You haven't had many sophomores carrying the torch from the very beginning of the season, but I know he's matured a lot during the offseason.
He's worked tremendously hard, and you get a lot of questions about him because of the importance of the quarterback position. You know, I my fear always when a guy has success, when a guy gets the starting position, you know, there's a chance that a guy's going to go on cruise control. And in my opinion, Thomas has worked harder after that happened than he had before. And so I'm very impressed with what he's done. His arm is strong. He ran the summer passing stuff that we do. And so he's ready to go, and we hope he's healthy. And, you know, and if he isn't, Jordan Thomas, the guy behind him, is doing the same things, and he's ready to go also.
Well, regardless of what Thomas plays quarterback, they've got the great seat in the house to watch one of the best running backs in the country, a Walter Payton Award watch list candidate, that being running back Kyle Manette.
Yeah, Kyle has had a great career here. He's a really good football player. He's a tremendous leader. He's a receiver out of the backfield. There's so many things he does so well. You know, we're going to use him. We're going to get our money's worth out of Kyle Manette. And he's that kind of guy. He really wants the ball and an opportunity to affect the football game. He's what we call a difference maker, really.
And we need to touch on your center, Ryan McKnight, as well, having that senior to anchor the offensive line.
You know, he'll block one guy, he'll double team, go up to another guy, but the maturity that he creates in the offensive line, in the offense, in the whole football team, the way he led, again, he was a great leader this summer. Really, we're going to get a lot out of Ryan also, and I just hope he stays healthy. He's had some dings of late and just needs to take care of his body. That's a tough position, center. I mean, there's a lot of piles that occur at that position.
So this Saturday, off to Delaware, we get off and running again with another season.
We're excited, really excited, and Delaware's going to have a jump on us. You know, Delaware has started. They've got a game under their belt. They've got more practices under their belt. It's going to be a great environment. A little bit of the CAA versus the Missouri Valley, you know, chip on our shoulder, chip on their shoulder. Bottom line is when we walk out on the field, 11 guys are going to try to do their best, and I'm looking forward to that.